I feel like I've lost a stone with worry. And here he comes, just hooked. And that there, folks, a wash of thorns on this. There we go. A small thornback ray. The thornback ray, I turn him round, saves the day. And you can see the thorns all the way down his tail here. He really has got some big, big thorns. The worm slid up the hook, up the line. I just turn him around. I do not need to get spiked. And you can see he's just hooked in there. Always watch your fingers. I'm going to use my special painted, one of those days, pliers to get that hook out. Hook's out. How easy was that? Well, that saved the day a bit, but I'm still going to move. I'm going to go out in deep water. That's on Ragworth. So as when it's like this, you just think, should I start? I've been here like 15 minutes. I wonder, I might give it another 30 minutes here. What do you guys think? There we go. Away goes Mr. Ray. You can see there's... Oh my God. Oh my God. It's only a bass, people. It's only a little bass, a little schooly bass. Now, I don't know whether he took when I moved it or whether he just grabbed it. I don't want to get spiked. Hang on, people. Now, look at that. That's a little turn up for the books, a little miniature bass there. You know, I think I've got to give 15 minutes because I just moved to this hump. I moved like half a mile and it seems to have paid off. So let's get him back and get some baits out. I will put those baits out. I've got to give it a go now, haven't I? I've got to. I use my own saying, don't leave feeding fish. And I think I should follow my own advice here. I'm not even followed by my plastic spoon. It's quite a big dogfish, actually. I did think I saw a bite there. And back Mr. Dogfish goes. A thin one. Double spoons this time, you can see, guys. So at least the dogs are on the bite. What's that bullhus? Yeah. This doggy's got some dark markings on him. There he goes. Look at it. Oh, he's come off. He's unhooked himself. Big old dogfish. Let's get this kitty off, I'll show you the place. This is just nerves, I've dispatched Mr. Place. And that is a really good one. A really good place there. He's on a one-way ticket to my frying pan. Why did those men move? Oh my God. Beauty. I can almost taste it now with the chips, the tartar sauce. I'm not giving it back to the wife, that's for sure. I have to go buy some more cutlery. Look at that. Manky old piece of lead. All those tackles. Radio check over. Roger, Roger. Home for tea, darling. Put the gin and tonic in the frying pan. You can see the boy's still down there, so I've kept the anchor rope short. Beautiful place, and he's going. Yes.